Making clean holes by hands is almost impossible for me, so I designed and built a custom drill press from scratch. Was it overkill for my needs? Maybe. Was it worth it? Absolutely, because the real gold isn't just in device itself, but in a few approaches I'll show you that can boost your next DIY project. Today I'll show you how a simple idea turned into a fully functional machine, designed in Fusion 360, printed at home and brought to life with a bit of trial and errors. As a reference, I used a mid-range drill press from AliExpress. It helped me to understand the basic construction and compare the overall cost. Unlike most existing builds, I decided to use ER11 collect chuck, mainly because of its compact size and precision. It can hold bits up to 8 mm, which fully covers my needs. The downside is that you need to buy separate cullets and swap them out for each drill bit. I had no idea what motors I used in factory-made tools, so I went with the default 775 TC motor, which is widely used in a similar DIY project. It offers a good balance between cost and performance. In my case, I choose the 24V 10K RPM version with a 5 mm shaft. I used 8 mm shaft for the chuck, rotating parts and some parts of the base as well. However, splitting long bar into chunks requires a grinder and some space. To connect the chuck to the motor, I bought a coupling and a pair of pulleys to transfer torque using a belt. And here I want to pause and explain why I chose that setup. The easiest and cheapest option would have been to connect the chuck directly to the motor, but a belt should theoretically reduce vibrations. It isolates the motor from axial forces which may extend its lifespan. By changing pulley size, I can adjust the chuck speed. And the most important, I've never worked with belts before, so it was just fun to try. To hold everything in place and allow belt tension adjustment, I used aluminum extrusion. It comes with special key nuts which works amazing with 3D printed objects. For smooth vertical movement, I used several linear bearings, one of them I accidentally broken. Also, I need few regular ones. Lastly, I bought a 70 mm spring. I couldn't find a standard option, so ended up spending more than expected on that part. As for electronics, there is nothing fancy. Just a simple PWM motor controller with support for bidirectional movement and standard DC barrel jack. The long shaft should be split into 4 chunks. To avoid additional expenses, I made them slightly longer, since the extra length doesn't really affect the machine. I also had to add a fillet and sand shaft a bit, otherwise they wouldn't fit into bearings. And then done, I printed all main parts. While printing, I found snag supports extremely useful for this kind of geometry. You get a smooth finish, just avoid curved shapes and fillets. Now I want to install the heating rods and bearings. To measure correct lengths for aluminum extrusion, I'm placing the pulleys and belt first. Then I cut it, leaving a little extra length just in case. From that point, I can secure all the parts on the extrusion and then install the motor and coupling. The first test revealed heavy vibrations, and here's how I solved it. First, I discovered that I couldn't install the chuck without drilling the shaft. Visually, it looks fine, but it had a slight wobble. So I bought a chuck with a pre-installed factory shaft. But in my case, I had to use Loctite because the shaft had a bit of play in the bearing. Second, I added a spacer under the pulleys, chuck and coupling. And then done, I assembled the base. And now it's time to enter the danger zone. I have zero experience with hand tools, so please, remove any chairs from the room. They shouldn't witness what's about to happen. After that, just a few steps remained. Mount everything under the platform, screw the arm, assemble the electronic box and add a few minor details. I finished this guy a few days before the video was published, so it hasn't seen much real use yet. From what I can tell, it handles wood perfectly. Brass and aluminum are a bit tougher, but I believe that mostly depends on the motor or power source. As for the construction, I noticed some side wobbles. It's not critical at all and could be fixed by adding a third axle. Another small issue. In the lowest point, the belt touched the extrusion. This can be easily fixed by using a larger pulley. But the real problem appears in the motor mount. I suspect the issue is caused by coupling, so I'll try to replace it. If that doesn't help, I'll add another bearing to eliminate the wobble at all. As you saw, the total cost is lower than factory-made device, but I can't compare durability just yet. Anyway, I plan to approve the drill as I will have time. If you have any suggestions or questions, feel free to drop me a comment. And I'd really appreciate if you subscribe to the channel, it helps a lot. Thanks for watching.